Number one, backdrop.
In 3, 2, 1.
So that backdrop shatters the glass on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, but on the S20 Ultra, the glass is surprisingly still intact, which, you know, could be due to Gorilla Glass 6, but we've seen Gorilla Glass 6 crack before. So I think the major factor here was that big old protruding camera lens. Due to the flat drop on its back from the machine, the camera hump actually took the majority of the damage here and enough of the impact to where the glass on the back didn't crack. Now, of course, different angles of drops can obviously produce different results, but in this controlled drop between the two phones, the S20 Ultra gets the easy win in round number one. Round number two, corner drop.
2, 1.
Neither phone takes too much damage from the corner drop, with the screens still remaining undamaged despite those ultra-thin bezels. The real difference here is the iPhone isn't nearly as scuffed as the Galaxy is, thanks to its stainless steel frame, which gives the iPhone the win here in round number two. Round number three, face drop.
In 3, 2, 1.
The face drop does major damage to the iPhone 11 Pro, with its screen cracking on the left edge and spiderwebbing all the way across the front, whereas on the Galaxy S20 Ultra, the damage isn't anywhere near as bad. While it did crack, the damage remained mostly confined to that left edge. I don't know if this is due to Samsung using stronger glass than the iPhone, or if the slight curvature on the screen somehow helps protect it, but either way, a significantly better result for the S20 Ultra, giving it the win in round number three. Bonus round. With both phones passing our 15-point inspection, they move on to the bonus round, where last time, the iPhone 11 Pro Max was able to make it through all 10 bonus drops. It definitely wasn't pretty, and the iPhone did lose a major function with its rear camera system failing, but the rest of the phone, from its display and speakers to Face ID, still remained fully functional. So let's see if the S20 Ultra can do any better.
Bonus drop number one. In 3, 2, 1.
Okay, so that first bonus drop leads to some major damage. The glass looks significantly worse with it now shattering all over, including across the fingerprint sensor, which while it didn't cause complete failure, the fingerprint sensor now only seems to work around 20% of the time. Everything else on the phone, however, still seems fine, so we'll keep on going.
Drop number two in a 3, 2, 1.
Two drops in, and that top portion of the screen no longer works. And the phone is also locking up intermittently, with the entire touchscreen becoming temporarily unresponsive, almost randomly for 20 to 30 seconds at a time. Now, we could stop the test right here, but because the phone technically recovers and could make an emergency call, we'll go ahead and continue.
3, 2, 1.
And after 9 brutal bonus drops, the S20 Ultra finally calls it quits. There's now major damage to the OLED display across the bottom, and the phone is just randomly touching different parts of the screen, making it unusable. So not the best result here, and definitely worse than the iPhone. Okay, so with all 4 rounds in the books, let's take a look at the scorecard. In the first round, the S20 Ultra's rear glass was able to remain fully intact, while the iPhone's glass was completely shattered. In the second, the iPhone's stainless steel frame was less scuffed than the S20's aluminum. In the third round, the S20 Ultra's front glass sustained significantly less damage. And then finally, in the bonus round, the iPhone was able to make it all the way through, while the S20 Ultra lost functionality in both its fingerprint scanner and its touchscreen very early on. But in the end, the S20's performance in the earlier rounds helped it score more points overall, making it the winner in this drop test. Anyways, that is it for me in this video. Thank you guys for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the very next episode.